There it is. It's Water Cooler Wednesday.
Yes, it is. And here today, Bev Johnson from WDIA AM 1070, Dwayne Benton with HollywoodRadio.com, and our very own Todd Demers, our weather expert. Good to see you folks. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Good morning.
Let's get to work.
All right.
All right. Calls to boycott the Oscars next month are gaining momentum. Actress Jada Pinkett Smith and director Spike Lee are among those who won't attend after only white actors were nominated for an Academy Award for the second year in a row. Bev Johnson, what do you think about this?
I think if Academy members want to boycott, they should, if they're members of it. And it's kind of strange, you know, Lily White, and it should be diverse. They should get the message from the Golden Globes, from the foreign folks who put that on,
right,
because it's very diverse. But, you know, but if you're a member and you don't want to go, don't go.
How about the MC? Should he step down, or does he have an opportunity to make a
Chris Rock, because you know he can bring some.
Yeah,
well,
it's such a big message. And I heard someone say the other day that he should come on and then say he's not going to do the show. That's an absolute horrible mistake to make. There is a lot of situational changes that need to happen in the Academy, and it should have happened before the nominations went down, because they said this happened last year. And I don't really care for the fact that Jada Pinkett Smith is speaking out because her husband has been nominated for a film. I want to hear actors who are not actually nominated, didn't have anything out, and are outraged about it. Not somebody who's really upset because my husband didn't get his nomination. So, you know, it's just a fine line here, but there are changes need to be made, and they should have been made way before this.
Todd, lack of diversity, what needs to be done?
Well, first of all, I hope Chris Rock goes ahead and does this, because he's a tremendous performer, and it's actually going to be a good stage for him to maybe say what he feels and continue to get a message out in a good way. I think, if anything, this is brought up a problem that maybe with the Oscars in who does the voting that creates the nominations that I don't think any of us thought about until these two people stood up and said, wait a minute, we got a problem here. And maybe there is a problem in the way the ballots are put together. And as long as they're investigating that and trying to figure out, is there a problem here? What can we do to solve it and have some more diversity? I think it's a good thing.
Yeah, because that group is largely male and white. So their frame of reference
and
is
older.
Their frame of reference
and older. All right, we'll keep it moving here.
Well, Madonna showed up 2.5 hours late to her concert in Nashville this week. Reba McEntire herself was in the audience and tweeted continually about it while she waited in the crowd for the Material Girl to appear. What do you think about that? Now, Madonna calls all the accusations that maybe she was drinking in Louisville and then perhaps at this concert sexist, too. So I'm curious about what you think about the whole thing. Should a performer ever get a pass on making people wait that long? And, you know, is the criticism founded?
Yeah, Dwayne, would you make us wait that long?
Absolutely not.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
At 30 minutes, maybe. if my water was not chilled to 70 degrees, maybe.
The makeup artist was a little bit late. Come on.
But the real story here, and we've all been to concerts, and we've all seen them start late. I think it is a disrespect to your audience to do that. And I've heard the people in the background say, oh, well, she's having some other issues, and she'll be out in about an hour or so. Certain people, they do this to. Certain people, they won't. When there's big money on the table in a big corporation, they'll show up on time. Now, whether Madonna did this or not, I think it's just she's been doing it so long, it's a disrespect.
Then
now
maybe it's time to sit down.
It's time to respect your audience again.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. I'm not going to be waiting 2.5 hours, unless it's the Eagles or Fleetwood Mac, and then maybe. But, you know, I agree with the term disrespect in that situation. That's just not taking very good care of your fans. As far as whether or not she was drinking and the reason why she was late, I think the truth will eventually come out on that, and we'll find out if that's the case or not. But right now, it's all speculation.
I agree with Todd. That's disrespect, and waiting that long. And I think, you know, give the fans their money back. You know, and why would you? That's disrespect.
All right. Here's a question for you. Would you split a hotel room with a complete, total stranger? There is a new app called Winston Club designed to help solo travelers save money on hotels. Winston Club says it will screen all users and match people based on age and gender preference. For now, it's available in Las Vegas, no surprise, Portland, Seattle, Los Angeles, and San Francisco.
Now, you know, Todd is cheap.
Oh, wow.
Are you okay over here?
This is so funny to me.
You know, this might work for some folks, and I'm very happy for them. It's not working for this folks. That's just a big flat
So you're saying you don't think the wife would go for it?
Or? No, and I think I would be able to find some someplace inexpensive enough to handle it on my own. Thank you very much. Again, I can see this might work for somebody. I mean, they have all these different little tiny cubicles and airports.
Well, you know, it may work for those folks who want to go on Match.com and all that stuff, but it's too many crazy folks out
Hello.
Here, Mary Beth.
Oh, I don't even want to do rides.
I don't know you,
and
I'm going to
car with somebody I
right.
don't know.
Oh my gosh! But Alex, I would share it with you.
I would hope so. Okay. And I'm not a stranger.
But he's strange.
Right. Dwayne, you said no.
I have a little experience in the hotel business, so I have met some weird people.
Let's so you've met that. Mary Beth.
Wow. I've met some weird people in the hotel business, and this is a horrible idea because people who live alone are over the top and eccentric and all these other things going on. And so you bring somebody who's just a plain Joe or versus somebody who's really like, this will be a disaster waiting.
Yeah.
Wouldn't sign up.
The first one will be in the news and we'll have it.
We'll have it. Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you.
Horrible.
Very much.
They're waiting for Madonna.
So funny.